this is the all-new Mazda BT-50. And it now shares the same fundamentals as the Isuzu D-Max, and not anymore the Ford Ranger. And at least based on my first impressions, this elegantly designed pickup truck did a few things right compared to its Isuzu sibling. In a sea of pickups trying to be macho and tough, the all-new Mazda BT-50's elegant sheet metal is a refreshing sight to see. Don't get me wrong, gusto ko naman din ng macho at gwapong pickup. But most of the things I purchase in life tend to lean towards elegance and sophistication. Halimbawa na lang, kung ako'y pagpipiliin between a Casio G-Shock or a Casio Edifice, I tend to prefer the latter. Though weirdly enough, I am also the same person who prefers NMDs and Ultra Boosts over Louboutins. But I digress. The Mazda BT-50 is an elegant pickup. And whether you prefer the macho-looking D-Max or the more sophisticated BT-50 is up to you. And sa ngayon, we're taking a look at two variants. A base model 4x2 and a top-of-the-line 4x4 variant with all the bells and whistles, such as full LED lighting, LED daytime running lights, LED fog lights, passive entry with push button start, LED tail lights, just to name a few. The lower 4x2 variant also gets LED headlights, but no LED daytime running lights, along with a smaller set of 17-inch alloy wheels, and the absence of smart entry and push button start. This 4x4 variant we're seeing, however, comes with the optional subtle fender flares, and optional tonneau cover, which will be equipped as standard on the first 200 units to be sold in the Philippines. Though personally for my taste, this elegant pickup looks better without the fender flares. Ngayon naman, dumako tayo sa elegant interior ng Mazda BT-50. And this interior highlights the two things that Mazda got right over the Isuzu D-Max.
So as for the interior of the Mazda BT-50, well, alam naman natin it's based on the Isuzu D-Max, no? So it's an interior that will feel familiar to those who came from an Isuzu. Pero as with every Mazda, they try to step up their interior into making it more premium compared to the competition. And that basically applies then with this BT-50. So in terms of yung soft touch materials niya, it's still the same amount sa D-Max, no? So meron ka dun sa dashboard, then dun sa may center console. Pero Mazda did a bit of more thought pagdating sa kanyang design ng dashboard. So mas marami kang silver trims, satin silver finishes, mga ganyan. So it looks a bit more premium compared to its Isuzu sibling, no? So these brown leather seats, they look really good. There's some more intricate stitching sa kanyang upuan. And yeah, it's a premium place to be in compared to other pickups, no? And then, more importantly, the one thing that Mazda did right dito sa BT-50 compared to the Isuzu D-Max is yung kanyang infotainment system, no? So what Isuzu did was they swapped out the global infotainment system for something that's, well, not exactly that good compared to the global infotainment system, no? So it's a good thing Mazda retained that infotainment system. It's still the global infotainment system you would find in the BT-50 sa ibang bansa and the D-Max. So the response is better and mas high res yung kanyang screen. And since ito nga isang OEM infotainment system, you're able to access some of the vehicle's functions through the infotainment system. Yun nga lang, may weird piano notes siya when you press the infotainment screen, pero that's about it. It's actually a nice system to use. Much nicer, to be honest, compared to the locally sourced one sa D-Max. So plus points for Mazda for doing the right thing in terms of their infotainment system.
May isang bagay na gusto ko pang i-highlight sa interior ng Mazda BT-50 na ito. Yes, that's right. This 4x4 automatic variant has a rear differential lock, which Isuzu only offered sa 4x4 manual variant nila. I think alam ko na which is the better pickup at this point. Though first impressions pa lang naman ito. The rear seats are largely the same as the Isuzu D-Max, kaya hindi na ako masyado nag-dwell dito. What's important to note here is that rear aircon vents and rear USB ports come as standard on all variants. The Mazda BT-50 only comes with one engine choice, and it's a 3-liter turbo diesel engine, which of course, unsurprisingly, is from the D-Max. Now, how does the Mazda BT-50 feel like on the road? Or rather, sa loob ng compound ng Mazda Philippines.
So behind the wheel of the new Mazda BT-50 and, well, sa totoo lang, we're driving around Mazda's compound sa ngayon. And in order to really grasp the pickup's driving dynamics, we really have to take it out on the open road. No? Pero for now, we're gonna be able to give you our first impressions view towards a BT-50. No? So in terms of the driving experience, ayun, the BT-50, just like the D-Max, feels refined. No? So it's a really, really refined pickup. The pickup feels nice and easy to drive. It's still a hydraulic power steering, di pa siya electronic power steering like in the right-hand drive markets ng BT-50 and D-Max. It's still a hydraulic steering, but it's a light hydraulic steering. So, iikutan ko siya with one finger ko lang. It's possible. Magaan yung hydraulic steering niya compared to the usual competitors like the Toyota Hilux, mga ganyan. It's not as light as compared dun sa Ford Ranger. Pero, yun nga, okay lang naman. At least on the upside, mas may feel ka to the steering wheel being a hydraulic power steering pa rin. You still have a good amount of feel sa wheel, which is important if you're going off-road. Oh, and speaking of going off-road, ito ang isa pang nagawa ng Mazda na tama na hindi nagawa ng Isuzu sa D-Max. Tingin kayo dito sa baba. Meron siyang diff lock. Itong 4x4 automatic variant that we're driving right now ay merong diff lock. Then as for the refinements sa ngayon, it really feels the same with the Isuzu D-Max. But yeah, it's better to take this out on the open road in order to feel the pickup much better compared to how the D-Max is, para mas magandang may experience tayo sa kung ano yung talagang driving experience niya. But so far, it feels similar to the D-Max. It's still a pickup, so may firmness sa kanyang ride, but it's not matagtag as what you would expect in a Toyota Hilux. Mas maganda ang ride niya compared to most pickups. Is it better than the D-Max? Maybe. Pero again, this might be just placebo sa ngayon. We really have to take the new BT-50 out on the same roads where I take my demo units para talagang alam natin yung comparison niya in a more scientific manner. Para mas consistent, syempre, yung road conditions natin and yung mga other variables natin. No? But anyhow, itong Mazda BT-50 na to, so far, is one of the more refined pickup trucks compared sa kanyang mga kalaban. No? Compared to the Toyota Hilux, compared to the Ford Ranger. This is one of the more refined pickups out on the market right now. So if you want a pickup with a bit of refinement and car-like experience, no, sure, the Navara has a better ride pa rin with its rear coil springs instead of having a leaf spring. Pero as far as leaf springs pickups go, or leaf spring pickups go, the D-Max is, or the BT-50 rather, is still one of the more refined, one of the more comfortable, and one of the more car-like in terms of the driving experience.
Just like the higher-end variants of the Isuzu D-Max, the Mazda BT-50 also adopts the same advanced driver assistance systems found in its Isuzu sibling, which means you get full-speed adaptive cruise control, lane departure warning, automatic emergency braking, blind spot warning, and rear cross traffic alert. Given that Mazda is trying to elevate their brand and making themselves more premium, you would expect that the BT-50 would cost more than the D-Max, right? Well, hindi ganun ang nangyari. Because sa totoo lang, the BT-50 costs less than the equivalent variants of the Isuzu D-Max. And that's despite the fact that the BT-50 has more features and it comes with Mazda's signature 5-year free maintenance program. This may just be a first impressions drive, pero sasabihin ko na agad ito. Mazda Philippines just brought in a much better Isuzu D-Max.